Okay, so here we go. This is the Kindle Fire home screen. In the middle of the display, you can see our content carousel. All the content I've used most recently is right there, ready, waiting for me in one click. So I was watching a movie, using the Amazon Silk web browser a little bit earlier, playing a little bit of Fruit Ninja, reading Wired magazine. I can scroll back to the top. I can click on Rango, resume where I left off. I'm going to switch it over to landscape. The high-speed dual-core processor, the high-quality 7-inch IPS display with 169 pixels per square inch, the form factor all combined make the device disappear when you're doing things like watching video. At any point, I can pause it, I can go home, pick it up where I left off on my HDTV, my Roku, or my TiVo. I'm going to go home, I'm going to leave it here in landscape, and up at the top of the display, you see that it says my name, Peter's Kindle. That means that all the content I currently own, my books, movies, my video, my music, is all going to be ready and waiting for me the first time I open up my Kindle Fire. So if I go into the music library, for example, I've got hundreds of albums available. I'm going to switch this back to portrait for a moment. Hundreds of albums available for me up on my cloud. I can store as many as I want to, and I can either stream or I can download those locally to my device. If I download, if I'm going to be out of Wi-Fi range, for example, I can play my music locally. Let's go with some Pearl Jam, near and dear to my Seattle heart. While the music is playing, I can go home, open up a book or a website or a magazine. In this case, why don't we go to the web? The Amazon.